Welcome to your French class. In this class, we'll understand le discours en direct. So let's start.
There are two ways in which we can talk about what someone has said. Either we can quote the actual words spoken by the person, or we can also talk of what was said without repeating the exact words. Okay. So rule number one. If the reporting verb is in present tense, we do not change the tense of the reported speech. Just write que to join both the sentences. For example, Jean dit, il fait beau aujourd'hui. Now, in this statement, Jean dit means the reporting verb is in present tense, so we are not going to change the tense of the reported speech. This is direct speech this time. Now, for changing it into indirect, we will write, Jean dit qu'il fait beau aujourd'hui, means Jean says the weather is nice today. Now we'll see the second rule. If the reporting verb is in past tense, we change the tense of the reported speech. Write que to join both the statements. For example, il me dit je vais bien. Now the reporting verb is in past tense. It is passé composé, so we will change the tense of the reported speech also. Il m'a dit qu'il allait bien. Now rule number 3. If the reported speech, means the spoken sentence, is a question that answers either in yes or no, then we use C to connect both the statements. For example, je lui ai demandé, est-ce que tu viendras? After changing it into indirect speech, the sentence will be Je lui ai demandé s'il viendrait. Now we have just added C to connect both the sentences because the sentence written in inverted commas was a question and it answered in yes or no. Or you can say whenever a question starts with est-ce, you need to add C. Now rule number 4. If the reported speech is a question that starts with quand, comment, combien, où, or pourquoi, etc., we write them to join both the statements. For example, il me demande où vas-tu? Now, after changing the sentence in indirect speech, it will be il me demande où je vais. Now, we have written où, which was already given in the question statement, and we write rest of the statement in simple form. Okay, without any inversion. Now comes rule number 5. If the reported speech is in imperative form, then we write the plus the infinitive form of the verb to join the statements. For example, il lui a dit par, and after changing it, the sentence will be il lui a dit de partir. So whenever there is any order, command, request or suggestion, we will frame the sentence using the plus infinitive form of the verb. Now comes rule number 6. If the reported speech is a question that starts with que or qu'est-ce que, then we write ce que to join both the statements. For example, il a demandé qu'est-ce qu'elle vous a dit. Now, after writing it in indirect form, it will be Il a demandé ce qu'elle nous avait dit. We have just written ce que in place of qu'est-ce que. Because the reporting verb was in past tense, so we have changed the tense of reported speech also. Now comes rule number 7. If the reported speech is a question that starts with que ou qu'est-ce qui, then we write ce qui to join both the statements. For example, il a demandé qu'est-ce qui te fait plaisir? So after writing it in indirect speech, it will be il a demandé ce qui me faisait plaisir. So qu'est-ce qui is replaced with ce qui. Now comes rule number 8. If the reported speech is a question, means the spoken sentence is a question that starts with qui, qui est-ce qui, qui est-ce, then we write qui to join both the statements. For example, elle m'a demandé qui est-ce que tu as invité. or qui as-tu invité? In both the cases, qui est-ce and qui should be replaced with qui. Elle m'a demandé qui j'avais invité. Again, the reporting verb is in past tense, a demandé, so we are going to change the tense of the reported speech also. Now we have a table which shows how the tenses change when converted to indirect speech. Now let's have a look on the words that show nearness in time or place.